On this week's show, Tesla wants to revolutionize your commute, Volkswagen has big plans for electrification, and the Chevrolet Spark electric cars you can rent for free for 2 hours in California. These stories and more coming up next on 10. Enjoying today's show on YouTube and want to read the stories we're referring to today? Just head to our website at transportevolved.com/TEN, where you'll find today's show notes, as well as links to the latest future car news, buying guides, tech primers, and car reviews. It's Friday, January 29th, 2016. I'm Nikki Gordon-Bloomfield, and I hope all of you along the I-95 corridor managed to stay safe last weekend with that monster snowstorm. Here in Oregon, well, we just had rain. Still, at least I didn't have to go anywhere, unlike those of you who have to drive to and from work every day. Unless you've got a particularly lovely commute, I'm guessing it's the daily char that you don't enjoy. But in a new YouTube video this week, Californian automaker Tesla Motors launched a bid to make that drive to and from work a lot better for everyone. How? Through the Autopilot self-driving feature of every Tesla Model S electric car, of course. In a specifically commissioned video, which we think is as close to a conventional ad as we've ever seen Tesla get, the viewer is shown how the various Autopilot functions offered on Tesla electric cars, from Tesla Summon to Auto Steer, Auto Lane Change, and Auto Park, combine to make the chore of driving to and from work a whole lot more pleasurable for everyone. Released on YouTube the same day as a second video from Tesla focusing on the ownership experiences of some of its customers in Hong Kong, the video is simplistic but clear in its message. Like so many other gadgets being sold to us today by tech-savvy companies, Tesla wants you to know the Model S and its autopilot functionality could change your life forever. And of course, it wants you to visit your local Tesla store for a test drive to find out for yourself. As you probably already know, those Tesla showrooms, owned and operated directly by Tesla, operate on a strict pricing policy set by Tesla HQ. And that means if you do decide to buy a brand new luxury Tesla Model S or Model X SUV, you won't be the victim of the usual price gouging that goes on at regular car dealerships every time a new in-demand model hits the market. But this week we brought you the news of a Tesla Model X Signature Series electric SUV being advertised at $215,000, more than 80 grand above the list price. How? It was being advertised as a used car on internet site Panjo, with just 500 miles on the clock. Its owner, someone who apparently had enough money to pay for a brand new fully loaded Model X and wait patiently in line for years, claims they no longer need an SUV, so they've just decided to sell the luxury car on. That's something they're entitled to do, but on this particular occasion and with such a high price markup, I smell something of a rat. Still, if you've got the money, who am I to tell you what to do with it? From someone selling their electric car for a lot of money now to a company which is seemingly spending a lot of money on bringing a large number of electric cars to market. I'm talking about Volkswagen, which confirmed this week, aside from Dieselgate, that it intends to bring a total of 20 new electric or plug-in hybrid models to market in the next 4 years across the entire Volkswagen Group brands. As anyone in the automotive world will tell you, 4 years isn't really very long, but as we explained on Wednesday this week, Volkswagen's claim to bring 20 new plug-in models to market by 2020 might be easier than it first appears. That's because Volkswagen has recently launched a toolkit specifically designed to bring electric drivetrains to its compact car lineup, as well as a next-generation battery pack that should give decent range, meaning developing large numbers of cars shouldn't be too costly. But the real reason for my skepticism comes from the fact that, like many automakers with multiple brands, Volkswagen happily sells off the same basic car with multiple different badges and multiple different names and a few nips and tweaks here and there. And since Volkswagen owns 4 mainstream car brands in Europe and 2 in the US, as well as a host of performance and luxury brands, it wouldn't be too difficult to imagine 4 or 5 base models becoming 20 or so with some clever rebadging and a little creativity. Sorry. We're off to Transport Evolve's former home of Bristol, UK for this next few story, as British cities of Milton Keynes, London, Derby and Nottingham. That's because these 5 cities became recipients this week of a £35 million government fund designed to encourage and accelerate the use of electric cars in preference to internal combustion engine ones. That money, part of a wider government project to support the development and use of electric cars, will see each of the winning cities run their own unique citywide perks, heavily influenced by the same perks that made electric cars so popular in Norway. Bristol, for example, will award owners of electric cars free parking within the city limits, as well as single occupant access to high occupancy vehicle lanes. Derby and Nottingham, which are sharing a joint award, will allow electric and plug-in hybrid cars to use the many miles of bus lanes each city has without fear of a fine. There's not enough time to detail all the prizes here and what they'll do with them, so head to our website if you'd like to find out more. British politicians, though, aren't the only ones trying to get people into electrically powered cars this week. So too is Hyundai, which announced that it intends to begin deliveries of the Hyundai Tucson hydrogen fuel cell electric car in Northern California in the near future. As we reported on Tuesday, the South Korean automaker says many new hydrogen filling stations are due to come online in the NorCal region in the coming months, and as such, it now believes that there are enough fueling stations open to the public to allow it to sell its hydrogen-powered SUV to residents of the San Francisco Bay Area. While it will open up a brand new market for the company, this particular news came as something of a shock to us, especially just 2 weeks after Toyota asked its dealers to stop deliveries of the Toyota Mirai hydrogen fuel cell sedan in the region after claiming there just weren't enough working hydrogen filling stations around to support the car's rollout. If we're honest, we think Hyundai's hydrogen move into Northern California has more to do with competition than anything else, but we're going to be watching very carefully in the coming weeks to see if those promised filling stations go online or not. From Hyundai now to its sister company Kia and its all-electric Kia Soul EV. As those who have been following in the electric vehicle world for a while will know, we've seen a number of automakers over the past few months promise a longer-range version of existing electric cars is on the way, either for this year or next, and prompted in part by the longer-range 2016 Nissan Leaf, which launched last summer. And this week, Kia can be added to that growing list. At least, that's according to UK magazine Autocar, which claims that the all-electric CUV will be given a modest-ranged increase, as well as a mild mid-cycle facelift, to make it more appealing and more competitive in the electric car marketplace. What you're seeing here is the current model year car, but if we're honest, the 2017 model year car won't look all that different to what you're seeing right now. The difference, hopefully, will most likely be under the floor, where a longer range, larger capacity brack could add what we guess could be another 10 or 20 miles of real world range over the existing Kia Soul EV. And that means real world ranges could be somewhere between 120 and 130 miles when driven carefully. Sadly, it's only a rumor at the moment, but if we do get anything more concrete to confirm, we'll let you know. Talking of longer range, you might expect that cars with longer range would be considered greener than cars with a shorter range. But this week, the American Council for an Energy Efficient Economy, or ACEE for short, crowned the Smart for Two electric drive coupe as the greenest car on sale today, a title that the vehicle has now won for 3 years in a row. The way in which ACEE comes to its conclusion is a little too complicated to explain in detail here, but it examines both the energy used in the manufacturing of the vehicle as well as the energy used during the vehicle's daily life and subsequent recyclability when it goes to the giant parking lot in the sky. As you might expect, the Smart for Two electric drive wasn't the only electric car in the top 10 list either, with the Chevrolet Spark EV coming in second place with the same 63-point score as the Smart for Two. Coming in third with 62 points was the Fiat 500e, while the Toyota Prius Eco, Volkswagen e-Golf, Nissan Leaf S and Nissan Leaf SV came in fourth, fifth, sixth and seventh places. Of course, the Smart for Two ED, with its tiny size and seating for two, isn't going to be for everyone's tastes and will be replaced early next year with a next generation model. But if you'd like to see what the current car is like to drive, head over to our YouTube site where you can see our review of the 2014 car, a fun, funky electric runabout. And finally, if the Smart for Two really is just too small for you, you could check out the second place Chevy Spark EV in Los Angeles for yourself, completely free of charge, courtesy of a brand new startup car sharing service called Wavecar. The service, which officially launched earlier this month, is making waves, pun intended, by offering members free two-hour rentals in the all-electric four-seater across Los Angeles. Booking and use is just as it would be for any other car sharing service, but there is a tiny little catch of getting 2 hours of free car rental. The cars are essentially mobile billboards. The concept's pretty simple. You drive the car where you want to go, and the car and the ad travels with you. Rather than charge customers for charging on driving the car, the company makes its money from selling advertising space on each vehicle. Use the car for less than 2 hours, and you're just a mobile advertisement from the time you're behind the wheel. In a world where we're inundated with advertising, it's a very unique service that we're sure some people will just hate. But hey, there is no such thing as a completely free lunch now, is there? And so too is it for Wave. Run over 2 hours of rental and you pay like everyone else. But if you get the free rental, you're fine. Just like 2 hours of free rental at Wave Car, your time is up for today's show. So it is time, unfortunately, for me to say goodbye. As always, you'll find all the news that's fit to print at our website at transportevolve.com. Catch up with us on Twitter at transportevolve, or check out our latest shows on our usual YouTube channel. And if you liked what you saw today, please consider keeping us independent and impartial by visiting our Patreon page at patreon.com/transportevolved and pledging your support from as little as $1 per month. And as I said at the top of the show, we've now reached our second goal. But for me to continue doing this as my only job, we need to break our third goal pretty soon, or I really do have to find another gig. So if you can, it'd be great to have you help out. As always, there's a lot we haven't managed to fit into today's show, including how CARB has certified a tri-generation facility as producing clean green hydrogen you can use in a hydrogen fuel cell vehicle. Volkswagen's Bud E concept car from CES impresses British magazine Autocar. SpaceX chooses the company that will help its own hypermile test track come to reality in Hawthorne, California. And we head off for a winter wonderland RAV4 EV experience to see how the car faces the white stuff. So when we're done, be sure to head to our site to read them all. Thanks for watching. I'm Nikki Gordon-Bloomfield. Have a great weekend, and until next time, keep evolving.